गुड मॉर्निंग विनीता जी. गुड
मॉर्निंग. गुड मॉर्निंग. हाउ आर यू?
वेरी गुड. आई एम फाइन, थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर जॉइनिंग. आई नो इट्स अ वेरी वेरी बिजी डे, बट नथिंग कुड हैव बीन बेटर देन टुडे.
यस, एग्जैक्टली. दैट इज व्हाट आई आल्सो फील, कि आज के दिन में 24 घंटे से ज्यादा होना चाहिए, लेकिन आज का दिन इतना अच्छा है कि चलते रहे, करते रहेंगे, कोई बात नहीं. एक्चुअली फॉर्चुनेटली यू नो टाइमिंग वाइज प्रॉब्लम हो गया, लेकिन द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पंचायती राज इज लॉन्चिंग वन ऑफ आवर फिल्म्स एंड बुकलेट्स टुडे.
ओके.
और उन्होंने टाइमिंग जो था वो उन्होंने चेंज कर दिया लास्ट मिनट में, इसीलिए ये थोड़ा सा दिक्कत है.
One or two minutes and we start.
Sure. I'm ready. आप जब बताएं, Toshi, मैं ready हूँ.
Toshi?
हाँ जी सर.
I think next 2 minutes time, we have a good number already joined. So next 2 minutes time, you can commence the session. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Sure.
Toshi, I think you should start now.
Okay, sir. Good morning, everyone. I would like to extend a very warm welcome to Ms. Vinita Singh, Major General G.S. Bal, Dean of Students' Welfare, Major General P.K. Sharma, Professor and Director, Amity Law School, and Dean, Faculty of Law, faculty members and students present here today. Constitution Day, also known as Samvidhan Divas, is celebrated in India on 26 November every year to commemorate the adoption of the Constitution of India. On 26 November 1949, the Constituent Assembly adopted the Constitution of India and it came into effect on 26 January 1950. The Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment on 19th November 2015, notified the decision of the Government of India to celebrate the 26th day of November every year as Constitution Day to promote constitutional values among citizens. I would like to take this opportunity to wish all of you a happy Constitution Day 2020. As part of the celebration this year, the Honorable President of India will be leading the nation at 11 a.m. today in reading the preamble of the Constitution of India to mark the occasion of Constitution Day. As per the request of UGC and the Bar Council of India, all the universities and the affiliated colleges should also join the Honorable President of India in reading of the preamble at the scheduled time. I would like to request Major General P.K. Sharma to do the honors on behalf of Amity Law School, Amity University, Haryana.
Thank you, Toshi. As a change, I would like to read the preamble in Hindi. I would request all the participants to repeat as per their choice. If they wish to speak in English or if they wish to speak in Hindi, I would like to. But on my part, I would be reading it in Hindi. And for the IT cell, Mishra ji, I have a small request to make. Mishra ji, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Pranshul has not yet been added into the panelist. He is still in the attendees. I request you to update him into the panelist.
Yeah, sir, I added him.
Yeah, please. So, Vinita ji, with your permission, may I now read the preamble in Hindi for everyone?
Of course. Bilkul.
Right. Uddeshika. भारत के लोग भारत को एक संपूर्ण प्रभुत्व संपन्न समाजवादी धर्मनिरपेक्ष लोकतांत्रिक गणराज्य बनाने के लिए तथा उसके समस्त नागरिकों को सामाजिक आर्थिक और राजनीतिक न्याय विचार अभिव्यक्ति विश्वास धर्म और उपासना की स्वतंत्रता प्रतिष्ठा और अवसर की समानता प्राप्त कराने के लिए तथा उन सब में व्यक्ति की गरिमा और राष्ट्र की एकता और अखंडता सुनिश्चित करने वाली बंधुता बढ़ाने के लिए दृढ़ संकल्प होकर हमारी इस संविधान सभा में आज तारीख 26 नवंबर 1949 के दिन एतद्द्वारा इस संविधान को अंगीकृत अधिनियमित और आत्मसमर्पित करते हैं. धन्यवाद.
थैंक यू सो मच सर. डॉक्टर बी आर अंबेडकर सेड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल मोरालिटी इज नॉट अ नेचुरल सेंटिमेंट, इट हैज टू बी कल्टिवेटेड. एंड विद दिस पर्पस इन माइंड एमिटी लॉ स्कूल प्रेजेंट्स अ वेबिनार ऑन The role of constitution in emerging new India on this auspicious day. At Amity Law School Gurugram, the vision is to strive to be an internationally recognized leader in socially relevant legal research and education in India. In pursuing its vision, Amity Law School has as its mission the creation and sustenance of a research-based academic environment that is grounded in values of social justice and excellence. The values of Amity Law School are fully aligned with those of the university, with a view to creating a culture that reflects these values. We the People is a network of organizations and individuals. They facilitate exploration, understanding, and action for being active and responsible citizens through events and in-depth training programs. They offer programs in schools, slums, skyscrapers, and anywhere that citizens of this nation reside, learn, and work. The organization, in a nutshell, helps the citizen to understand the Constitution. Ms. Vinita Singh's main focus over the last 25 years has been in building people's capacities on rights and responsibilities within our democratic and constitutional framework. She's worked extensively in the areas of livelihoods, citizens' rights, and civics education. Across all these areas, she has mainly focused on building people's capacities to empower themselves with skills, knowledge, and attitudes to take charge of their own lives. She has been involved in the setup of a number of organizations, including International Resources for Fairer Trade, Satak Nagrit Sangathan, and National Homeworkers Group. Currently, apart from undertaking few key consultancies, she's fully engaged with transforming civics education in India as managing trustee with We the People. Her education includes bachelor's in economics and two masters, one in management from SP Jain Institute, Mumbai, and the other in social policy from the London School of Economics. May I now request Ms. Vinita Singh to address the gathering? I would like to request the attendees to post their questions in the chat box. Over to you, ma'am.
Great. Very nice to be with all of you on this day. And very nice, of course, to read the preamble, first thing in the morning or very early in the morning. It is an important day because of many different reasons, of course, and the adoption of the Constitution is one of those reasons. But we were put on a path on this day. And that path is what determines the direction that the emerging new India is going to take. It is the path that we have been meant to take. And therefore, I think for us on this day, what I would like to do is to remind ourselves of what this this guidance is on. Because when you emerge and you take a path for the new India, let us have in front of us the guide, jisko hum mardarshika bolte hain, the guide and those values that will actually guard us. So I would like to take us through those, keeping the focus on the preamble. We know that at many different times, that is the important thing that will always be with us in our journeys. I'd just like to take 1 minute and wear my mask, if you do not mind. Just 1 sec. I'd like to keep up with the rules, of course, while I'm in the car. Just 1 moment, please. I hope I'm still audible. Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, you're audible. You're audible.
Okay, great. Wonderful. Right. So, the document or the one page that...
Ma'am, you're not audible.
Many audible hain. Who's saying not audible? Ma'am?
I think I'm... audible? Shall I
go? Yeah, you are audible, ma'am. You are audible.
Okay. All right. So, what is that container of values or the guide that we are talking about? It is that one page that we just read out. And that is the one page that I'd like to focus on in terms of looking at what is the role of the Constitution in the emerging new India. The role of the Constitution is, of course, to look at, providing the framework for how laws will be made, how they will be executed, and the entire structural framework which the citizens are meant to engage with. However, to me, the most important part of the Constitution are the values that it embeds first in the preamble, and then those values are carried forth in all aspects of the Constitution. The Constitution is a detailing of the values that are embedded in the preamble. And if the rest of the Constitution wouldn't follow the values, then really that would be not an extension of the vision and the spirit of the Constitution. So let's look at these values. And to me, each one of us, that is the real guide for us in our college, in our study life, in our work life, in our home life. It is the guide for the government, but essentially it's a guide also for each citizen. For you and me, basically. You know, let's not take it very far. It's for you and for me. It's a guide. In the new India that we talk about, what does this guide tell us? The guide is telling us that we, the people of India, hum Bharat ke log, we will secure for ourselves certain values. The way the preamble is written, you can see that it, of course, constitutes India into a certain framework. But if you go a little ahead, it says, we will secure for all citizens these values. Now, let's talk about the first three values: equality, liberty, and justice. Right? So, what it's saying is that we have to secure these values for ourselves. What is the value of justice? It doesn't mean the judicial system as such at this moment, as a value. means impartiality and fairness. That's the value that we have to secure. Impartiality and fairness. The second is the value of equality of status and opportunity, which actually equates more to equity. We are securing an equity-based life for ourselves. We may be different in many ways. In that sense, we are not equal in every way in which we are, but we will secure equality of status and of opportunity, jisko hum Hindi mein samta bhi kehte hain. And the third value, which is of liberty, which means the freedom to express ourselves, to fulfill ourselves, to lead the life we want to wear the clothes we want to eat the food we want to express our thoughts and actions in whichever way we want to. These are the three critical values first that we need to secure for ourselves in this new India. I'm going to look at two aspects of this. When we say secure to all citizens, let me first say one of those all citizens is me. Me, myself, right? So securing these values for myself is a very important direction of the preamble to the Constitution. In this new India, as we move forward, secure these values for yourselves. In any situation, these values are such basic values that sometimes they are unconscious. In such a way that sometimes you get affected by them, sometimes there's a violation. Many other people may not come to know about it, but you, in your heart, inside you, understand the violation of it. You feel it. You feel when someone has been unfair to you. You feel it when someone has treated you unequally. Jab hamare saath barabari se bartav nahi hota hai, to chahe kisi ko bhi na samajh aaye, hame samajh aa jata hai, mujhe samajh aa jata hai. And also the violation around my ability to express my thoughts and beliefs is something that I can feel inside me. You know, in this time of COVID, we are talking about, you know, almost choking on our breaths. You have the feeling of choking on your own thoughts if you're not allowed to express them. And in this new India, I would like each one of us to keep the direction of the preamble that you are meant to secure this for yourself. It's possible that people around you might violate it for you. You may not be able to, you may not be allowed to speak freely. Of course, you must speak with dignity, but you must also speak with respect. But if you're not allowed to speak your mind with dignity and respect, or you are treated unfairly or unequally, then you must stand up for yourself. This new India is about standing up for yourself. People will support you. People will support me, but the most important person for myself is me. In the coming years, this ability to stand for myself is going to be tested as always, but there has never been a better time or never been more opportunities available for us and systems available for us to speak our minds, to be treated fairly and equally. खुद के लिए खड़ा होना, अपने इन मूल्यों के लिए खड़ा होना, ये हमारे न्यू इंडिया में सबसे बड़ी बड़ी बात हमारा प्रीएम्बल हमें कहता है. द सेकेंड थिंग दैट इट्स सेइंग टू यू इज व्हेन वी से सिक्योर फॉर ऑल सिटीजंस, देन ऑल सिटीजंस बिकम वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इट मीन्स आई हैव टू सिक्योर फॉर मायसेल्फ एंड आई हैव टू सिक्योर फॉर अदर्स. Which means that just as you have the right to be treated fairly and equally, and you have the freedom to speak your mind and your belief, it means that every other citizen has the same right as you. Ye values har jane ko equally apply karenge. Now, that's a very important thing for us to understand. मैं जब अपना पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू रखता हूं या रखती हूं, सामने वाले को वही पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू रखने का, कोई और पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू रखने का सॉरी, वही अधिकार. आपको पसंद हो ना ना हो वो अलग बात. यू मे अग्री, यू मे डिसएग्री, यू मे लाइक इट, यू मे नॉट लाइक इट, बट दिस गिव्स एन अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर डायलॉग. But does it mean that the person doesn't have the right to say it? No. So in this new India, when people are finding their voices, people are expressing themselves, and you know more than me how all methods of expression are being used. Of course, we must continue to emphasize dignity and respect for everyone, but if I do not agree with someone, there is no good reason to not listen to anyone. If I do not like the way a person is, there is no good reason to not listen to what they have to say. The more we listen to voices which are very different to us, the more we are going to understand and secure these rights for everyone. And that therefore comes to the second point. When I secure for all citizens, I must be mindful of the hierarchies that I carry in my own mind. At the beginning being said that Ambedkar ji said that constitutional morality is not a natural sentiment. It is not. We talk about equality being a core human value, but the way in which we approach the world is hierarchy based. Someone is bigger or smaller. I am different, I'm a woman, you're a man, a transgender. The way in which we look into the world is by segmenting in terms of hierarchies. The hierarchies may be in terms of gender, caste, whatever the hierarchies are. Sometimes the hierarchies are in terms of Hindi kaun bolta hai aur Angrezi kaun bolta hai. The hierarchies may be in different ways, but these hierarchies are in our minds. I would say in the new India, we've got to reflect on the hierarchies we carry. Through our life, culturally, the hierarchies that we carry, we have to be able to reflect and break these hierarchies, because that comes in the way of securing these values for everyone, including ourselves. If there's one message in the new India is grab your own rights and secure the rights of others by breaking the hierarchies that our families, our cultures, our traditions may have set up for ourselves. Not all of them do. But sometimes they do. That is what we need to be looking at. Now, let us move to the third thing that we need to look at in terms of the direction of the preamble. And for that, I'd like to take us to the fourth value mentioned in the preamble. And that is the value of fraternity. Now, if you look at the preamble, aap dekhoge, it says secure to all citizens, justice, equality, and liberty. And in the way it's written, the fourth value is written, it is promote amongst us all fraternity. See the words that are written there. See the way in which they are framed there. What is it telling us, each one of us? It is saying that while I secure these three values for myself and others, I have a role in promoting fraternity. It's a different verb. The verb is to promote. And that is a very interesting way to look at this idea of fraternity. The way in which we look around us, this idea that we may be very, very different from each other, but we are still together, that we are still a polity that is together, is the idea of fraternity. Fraternity does not mean that we don't disagree. We must disagree. But can we disagree? Can we get about with all our differences with dignity for the individual? Individual. And that is the one thing that I believe is going to be severely tested in the new India. The methods of dialogue, given our character limits on Twitter, given the need to have very attractive black and white sloganing and messaging on Instagram, on Facebook, on WhatsApp, all our conversations have come down to positions. And the stronger the position, the more likes or dislikes you are going to get. That makes our mind, in a way, trying to always find or move to a position that is so deeply embedded that we find that we don't even know how to move from that or to listen to somebody else. These spaces are excellent spaces, but when we are talking about highly, highly diverse people, to understand people, we have to be able to get into their shoes. We have to be able to get into dialoguing. And for that, to me, is going to be the biggest challenge for promoting fraternity. But because that's a value that the direction of the preamble is giving us, in my view, that's the one effort we have to make exceedingly importantly coming in the time coming forward. Hame bahut mehnat karni padegi ki hum alayda dharmon ka, alayda drishtikonon ka, different views, we are able to listen, understand, may not agree, but listen and understand. Because when we are able to do that, we are able to establish that we may be very different, but we are still a part of a polity that essentially works on certain human values. To the new India going forward, this is going to be critical. We have to find smaller spaces of interaction and dialogue between very different people. I would say, find people who are extremely different from yourself. In the Constituent Assembly, it was tried that very unlike-minded people come together. Make your spaces like that. Try to learn more about people who are not like you. And develop the ability to dialogue and to listen. This is going to be critical skilling in the time to come. Because it's with this fraternity that the other three values are going to be secured. If there is not that feeling of togetherness and support to each other, the other three values are going to be in peril. So, in conclusion, for the new India, the three values of equality, justice, and liberty, securing for myself and for all citizens, is the key message of the preamble to the Constitution. and working actively on promoting dialogue amongst diversity is going to be a major ask from all of us. And I know that you, me, and all of us, but especially you, because of the opportunities you have got, you are in a wonderful position to be able to secure and promote these values going forward. All my best wishes with everyone here. Let us keep reminding ourselves. Let us move ahead with inspiration. We belong to a country that is absolutely unique in the way in which it wants to place itself in the world. Let's be part of this fantastic experience. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you. I'd like to end here. Thank you.
Toshi, I think there are some questions you may, there are two questions in the question answer box you may wish to request, ma'am.
Yes, sir. So, ma'am, we have few questions.
Yes.
One of them is from Dr. S.K. Tripathi. He is a faculty at Amity Law School only. So
yes.
He's asking, the ideals and objectives of constitution are the ideals and aspirations of the people living in different conditions from today, 70 years back now. So every aspect of social and political life has changed. So why there should not be a new constitution as per the aspirations of people today?
Actually, interestingly, our constitution is based on what you call essential human values. The situations would change, you know, the experiences or even the thoughts of many people will change, but we will essentially remain human beings. These values, these ideals, they are ideals because we constantly work on them. They are not ideals in the way that they are not achievable. In fact, every moment, we are walking the line of these values. When you and me, we are talking, we are walking these lines of these values. So the Constitution of India is the basis. Of course, we can get other things in the Constitution. Constitution itself gives the space for relooking at it. Yes, of course it does. However, the important aspect of the Constitution is that it is based on essential human values. And we are not going to change that. We are essentially going to be remaining as human beings with all our issues, our problems, with all the mindsets that we carry. But these human values remind us when we are treated in our heart. You cannot tell a child, why did you feel bad about something or that? The child or anyone else, even an elder, feel certain things because it goes against certain essential human values. And that is why our constitution has been able to thrive and survive these 70 years, and it will continue to be relevant in the future. However, yes, there are many circumstances, social conditions. I mean, for instance, we never thought about the fact that we will have to look at gender, we will have to look at homosexual relationships, you know, and therefore the right, the equality rights and the right to life slowly expands over time to cover interest groups and nations and issues that may not have been thought at the time that the Constitution was made. Sure, absolutely. And that is why the Constitution gives the base law. it gives the values. It says this is the structure. It says you can even change the structuring, the not the basic and essential structure, but you can make amendments. And the most important thing is that the Constitution gives you the base for making laws. Laws need to respond to the social changing times. Laws can be changed, but the essential framework of making those laws and the basis on which those laws will be made is what the Constitution gives us. And to in that sense, the Constitution therefore has the longevity. As long as humans remain as confused and as powerful as we are, this Constitution will serve us.
Thank you so much, ma'am. The next question we have is from Dr. Vijaypal Singh. He's saying that independence of judiciary is the part of basic structure, but Justice Arun Mishra's statement that the Prime Minister is a versatile genius has set off a debate about judicial conduct. What do you think about the relationship between government and judiciary?
In my view, it is the constitutional view that the judiciary must be the impartial arbitrator. It must be the impartial interpreter. And therefore, it must direct the executive and the legislature. This is the role of the judiciary. It plays a critical role in terms of checks and balances. And that is why that framework must remain. See, the checks and balances is the principle that must remain. Now, there are many areas where we falter. The judges falter, people falter, the administration falters, our politicians falter. But the role for all of us is that if one falters, we must limit ourselves even more. If there are some deviations, if there are some things that happen, we must question them. Where we believe that a certain principle is being compromised, let's say. If we believe that or we think like that, we must demand answers. We must ask questions. Let us focus on the principle and the values, and on the basis of these principles, ask questions to anyone who inhabits these institutions. So yes, there will be deviations. There will be issues and problems. We may not be able to implement on a regular everyday basis. There may be points that we falter. We falter as institution leaders. We falter as citizens. But it actually must recommit ourselves to the principle. And जब हम क्वेश्चन पूछते हैं हमें प्रिंसिपल लेके पूछना तू तू मैं मैं की यहाँ पे बात ही नहीं है. We must therefore understand the principle, ask questions based on principles, so that we can help the process of being truly aligned to these principles. This raising fingers और ये जो हमारा individuals का तू तू मैं होता है, that's perhaps not the most helpful way of helping us align to the principles and values of the Constitution.
So, ma'am, the next question we have is from Mr. Sandeep Kumar. He's requesting to enlighten us on the status of independence of judiciary at this point of time.
At this point of time, there are many challenges that we are facing. There are challenges that we have faced at many different times in the last 70 years. And I think that because constitutional morality is such a sentiment and a system, it requires it requires everyday practice. You know, it's not something that comes naturally to us. And we have always been a nation. Well, we have not always also been a nation. We are learning nationhood. We are learning how to be citizens and individuals in the backdrop of communities and groups. We have been a group-based society. In that, with the Constitution's focus on the individual, with the Constitution's protection of individual rights, we are learning. We are learning. We as citizens are learning. I think institutions and their leaders are also learning. And in this, there will always be challenges. The challenge today, we experience it, therefore we feel it even more. But the challenge is I think, a challenge that will go on for many years coming forward. Because we are constantly having to challenge the way in which we think, the hierarchies that inhabit our minds, the way we are brought up in our families. The person who is a policeman is also a duty bearer. He needs to learn, or she needs to learn, what the duty bearer position means vis-a-vis an individual in his or her village. These are matters of our attitude that we have to cultivate. And that's exactly what the word that Ambedkar ji used. We have to cultivate it. Matlab, duty bearers ko cultivate karna hai, hume bhi cultivate karna hai. Hamari duty as a citizen ko bhi humko cultivate karna hai. Ye challenging hone wala hai, kyunki hum sochte nahi hai na aise. And today it's even more. Today the kind of pressures you face are even more. Society in itself is going through throes of change here. This time in the last 70 years, this time is the most fast-paced time than we've ever had before. So challenge to hone wala hai, judiciary mein bhi challenge hone wala hai. Har institution mein challenge ho raha hai. And I think the important thing for us is to continue the questioning, continue to bring our issue forward where we find that certain principles, values are not in alignment. Where they are in alignment, we must support and also definitely congratulate ourselves. कि हमने हमारी हायरार्कीज हमारे सोचने के तरीकों में बदलाव लाया है. ये बहुत महत्वपूर्ण बात है, ये बहुत मुश्किल बात है. सो आई वुड से द चैलेंज इज देयर, लेट्स राइज अप टू इट इन एवरी इंस्टीट्यूशन इंक्लूडिंग द जुडिशरी.
मैम, वन ऑफ आवर स्टूडेंट्स मिस उजाला सिंह सेज दैट certain values like equality gets denied to women in their very homes.
Yes.
She says that I wish to secure these values for myself and all other women, but this discrimination is embedded in the general mentality. How to mold so that the new India has more women who can enjoy their rights?
That's such an important question. I think I'm sure my mother must have asked the same question of herself when she was bringing me into this world. My mother showed leadership in a world that was maybe, you know, certainly 50 years back, I'm 50 this year, was more embedded in discrimination than even it is at the moment. I was the third child, coming after a boy and a girl. Right, there was the girl and the boy was already there, right? So, wo jo typical एक लड़का एक लड़की और परिवार वगैरह. एंड माय नानी एक्चुअली आस्क्ड माय मदर, व्हाट इफ दिस थर्ड चाइल्ड इज अ गर्ल, व्हाट आर यू गोइंग टू डू? एंड माय मदर सेड, आई विल ब्रिंग हर इनटू दिस वर्ल्ड, हूएवर शी इज, व्हाटएवर जेंडर शी और ही इज, and if she is a girl, I will bring her to face the world and bring leadership to the world. The role my mother played is the role I will play of ensuring that me, myself, and others, other girls, and also people, transgender and men who are discriminated, should actually find their voice. Each of us have a very critical role to play. We are leaders in whichever spheres of influence we have. We influence a lot. Us sphere of influence mein, agar aap apne aap ko leader mante hue, is discrimination ko challenge karengi, aap in values pe jiyengi. Aur ye jeena aapko roz ek question mark dene wala hai. People around you are constantly going to give you an opportunity to question, what will I do in the face of discrimination? Discrimination is something that you face on a daily basis. You have to even stand up to it on a daily basis. It's not easy. It's in fact very tough. But you have, I think we have to understand ki hum kaam karte hain, padhte hain, ye sab cheeze karte hain. लेकिन हमारी जिंदगी का एक बहुत बड़ा पहलू है कि हमें इन मुद्दों पर और इन मूल्यों पर खड़ा रहना है. उसके लिए समय लगता है, उसके लिए चर्चा करनी पड़ती है, उसके लिए कभी कभी थप्पड़ भी खानी पड़ती है. और थप्पड़ तो नहीं, पर जरूर कभी कभी यू डू फेस अ लॉट ऑफ प्रेशर फ्रॉम डिफरेंट पीपल. As I faced, for instance, at the time that the equal distribution of property for my family was coming into question. You have to challenge sometimes the way in which families work, right? It's not easy, but it has to be done. And so welcome to the world of hard work. Welcome to the world where we are going to all have to be able to, you know, constantly challenge. And so it's not going to be easy, but all the best to you and to me and to all the women of this world. Sorry, there's no easy answer to it, but karte rehna padega.
Yes, ma'am. So next we have Miss Ananya Gore. She's saying that considering the idea of New India, where we emphasize on standing for ourselves, don't you think that the Constitution does not provide the required rights to the third gender to stand for themselves? Shouldn't there be amendments relating to basic rights of third gender where they can stand for themselves?
I think that the legal framework has been slow. In fact, I think that if we broadly interpret the Constitution, we look at, you know, Article 14, when we look at or 15, if I can be more specific, the understanding perhaps at that time may have been around men and women, but certainly the understanding or the scope for lawmaking to protect this fundamental right of discrimination on the basis of gender stand. Understanding of the needs of different genders have changed or have moved forward. You know, many of my friends are transgender, and when we go on about, we as women go on about certain discrimination, they immediately point out that the fact that we have made a huge amount of progress, but for transgender, the laws and the framework really needs to be more supportive. And they are right. Absolutely right. And so this brings us again back to the point. The Constitution provides us the framework. The Constitution, in the way in which our rights are written, are not specifying this gender or the other. if you feel that there needs to be certain amendments made to bring in that, certainly one must do that. However, in my own opinion, the framework of the Constitution is flexible and broad enough to provide for lawmaking for specific interest groups. And it is the lawmaking for this interest group that we must focus on now, by the community of transgender themselves and by other communities in support of them. And I if this is an issue that really concerns you, you want to do something about it, I can connect you, in fact, to several groups working in the area of lawmaking or changing laws for the betterment of transgender.
Okay, ma'am.
Next. Yeah, I have a hard stop in another. Literally 5 minutes, okay?
Okay, so can we have one more question and then we'll have the concluding remarks?
I think, Toshi, two questions. One is from Dr. Sugato and one is from Monica. Ma'am, just bear for 5 minutes. I think yes. You'll be able to cover this. Please.
Sure.
Okay. So, ma'am, Dr. Sugato Mukherjee says that a petition in the Supreme Court has triggered a legal debate on whether whether citizens of India can be compelled to be secular when the Constitution permits them the right to practice, profess, and propagate their own religion under Article 25. The petition has sought the deletion of the words secular and socialist from the preamble, and how far that is a justifiable step in so far as the Indian heterogeneous scenario is concerned.
I think the petition was rejected in my understanding. I think it was rejected on the basis that actually I don't know the reason for the rejection, but it was, I'm sure. But I will just present my view on this. You're absolutely right. We have the freedom to profess and practice and to propagate, actually, our religions. And in that sense, the citizens of India are not meant to be secular. We are, if you would like to not have a religion, or you would like to, have a religion which calls itself secular, that's another thing. But the point is that you are meant to be as Hindu as you want. You are meant to be as Muslim as you want. You are meant to be as Christian as you want. That's the whole point of the freedom of practicing of religion. And therefore, in that sense, the citizens are not meant to be secular. The citizens are meant to be practicing their own religions and being respectful of other religions. But I can be as Hindu as I want, and I can propagate my religion as much as I want while keeping the respect for other religions. The word secular in the preamble refers to the state. If you see the five words, which is constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, these five words are the features of the state. The institutions of the state. The state is meant to be secular in that the state has no official religion. And that is exactly how the word secular must be interpreted. It is interpreted in the light of the state, not of the citizens. The state has no official religion, and that's the way it stays. And they must hold all religions equal, but in itself, the state of the India has no official state religion. I hope I've answered that question.
Thank you. So, ma'am, our last question for the day. Ms. Monica Yadav, Associate Professor for Amity Law School, she says that the Vice President, Mr. Venkaiya Naidu, in his address at a conference yesterday, said that recent judicial pronouncements give a distinct impression of judicial overreach. Our constitution doesn't have a clear-cut separation of powers. Do you think this gives the scope of overreach?
Yes, there will be this tussle. In the last question also, we talked about it in the sense that what is this separation? How will these institutions, you know, move in relation with each other? There is certain framework accorded, but in the doing of things, there will always need to be some level of interpretation, going back, understanding more, and aligning more. Now, in the cases that we feel that perhaps the executive is not delivering enough, perhaps there is some element where the judiciary comes in and provides some overreach. There is need for the judiciary also to correct itself on that. Play to its role, and the executive plays to its role. However, as we understand in the implementation of things, there will be this, I won't call it tussle, because tussle somehow seems antagonistic, you know, it seems very, but there is this, shayad Hindi ka shabd achha rahega, kashmakash kahin par. And there are cases where judiciary has completely kept to its, you know, for instance, we were, you know, I'll give you the example of the Supreme Court when this whole Section 377 came up, and while the Delhi High Court had ruled in favor of the fact that this should be struck off, the Supreme Court kept to the position that it was the legislature which will take a view on that. At that time, all the activists were very upset, you know, because we felt that it was a place where judiciary could have made that interpretation better. But the judiciary at that time, the Supreme Court kept to the distribution of powers and made a statement that the legislature will look into this, and only the legislature has the power to strike off any section of any act. Right. So in some cases, judiciary takes a more proactive role. Right. These are alignments. Sometimes they shift, sometimes they come together. In our position, I think each one of us, duty bearers and citizens, must continuously reflect, keep ourselves abreast of the situations, look, relook, review all the time the principles and values of the Constitution, and ask questions based on that. The more questions we ask, and in fact, it is our duty to be asking these questions. The more questions we ask, the better we will contribute to the making of the new India, because these kind of kashmakash, is type ke challenges aate rahenge. Hame us par ye karna hai ki hum prashn kare, apna behavior badalte rahe, question karte rahe, aur uski taraf, we have to align ourselves and our institutions towards the principles and values of the Constitution. That's my interpretation of this.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your insightful thoughts and igniting the minds of those present with us today. I would like to request Mr. Pranshul Pathak, Coordinator, Amity Law School, to say a few words and express his views. Pranshul, sir.
Thank you, ma'am, for your wonderful deliberation. And I believe that it is going to help all law students and the faculties to understand the Constitution a bit more. And Toshi, thank you for inviting me to say a few words, because yesterday we have celebrated Dev Diwali, which I considered as the most pious day as per Hindu mythology. And as a member of legal fraternity and as a law student, I considered this day as the most pious day, of a year. And I was just looking at the question, and I saw that a kind of mystique is injected by some of the question. There are questions regarding secular character of the Constitution and that whether we require new Constitution or not. So I must tell you that when we enacted Constitution and when we adopted it on 26 January 1950, immediately, next year, Professor Jennings was called to deliberate over the constitution and how he finds Indian constitution. And in his three lectures, conclusively he stated that he find Indian constitution as too long, too rigid, and too prolix that it is not going to endure. Okay. And there was one study, it was conducted by Harvard Law School, and the title of the study is The Lifespan of Written Constitution. And in this study, the written constitution right from year 1789 to 2006, they were analyzed, and the result which was shown is that there are around 50%.
I'm extremely sorry, but I really need to be going. So I accept your thank you very much. And thank you for inviting me for this event. And, you know, have a great deliberation going forward. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you. Thank bye you, bye.
We will request you once the situation improves. We'll request you to come to university and we'll have a one more dialogue on this.
Sure. Thank you absolutely. So much. And I also want to place before you that, you know, my education is not really in law. I approach this from a citizen's perspective.
Very
so
good.
I need to learn all the more from you also. thank you very much. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. We'll continue with our... Pranshul, yes. Please continue.
Thank you, sir.
So I was saying that a study was conducted and by the name The Lifespan of Written Constitution. And in this study, fact was discovered that, you know, the constitution which were written from year 1789 to 2006, out of those, the average lifespan of 50% constitution was just 17 years. Okay. 7% of them, they, you know, even could not make up to their second birthday. And 50% of the constitution, you know, they only will go for more than 50 years. 19% of the constitution, they only pass the time frame of 50 years. Okay. So it is very weak. I congratulate, you know, all of you as a citizen of India that our constitution now, it is the 71st year. So now we have proved Professor Jennings wrong when he said in year 1951 that it is not going to endure for a long time. Okay. And secondly, I just want to deliberate on the question asked by Dr. Tripathi, sir, my Guruji. And he said that why we don't frame a new constitution. So changing to new India and, you know, emerging as a new India is just like making new house. Okay. So I must explain it in a manner ki jab hum koi naya ghar banate hain, ठीक है, हम नया घर अच्छा बनाते हैं, पर हम अपने पुरानी घर की चीजों को और उन पुरानी अच्छी यादों को अपने साथ में नए घर में शिफ्ट करते हैं. सो सेइंग दैट नाउ द आइडियोलॉजी इज चेंज, माइंडसेट इज चेंज, सो वी मस्ट अडॉप्ट अ न्यू कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. आई थिंक इट्स नॉट अ गुड आइडिया बिकॉज वी मस्ट फॉलो द आइडियोलॉजी एंड द प्रिंसिपल विच आर इनमरेटेड बाई आर फाउंडिंग फादर्स. दो वी यू नो चेंज अवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन as per the new challenges, but we must adopt those ideology. So these are the comments from my side, Toshi. And as Director sir told me that the message which I circulated in the group today morning, I must reiterate it here. So the message which I circulated is that however good a constitution may be, if those who are implementing it are not good, it will prove to be bad. But however bad a constitution may be, if those implementing it are good, it will prove to be good. A great man is different from an eminent one in that he is ready to be the servant of the society. So long as you do not achieve social liberty, whatever freedom is provided by the law is of no avail to you. We all are Indians, firstly and lastly. So with these thoughts, I must wish you all a very happy Law Day, Vidhi Divas. And sir, with your permission, today morning I wrote a poetry because I consider this day as a most pious day, and I wrote a poetry. So with your permission, if you permit, then I must, I want to, you know,
most certainly.
Share please. It with you all. Though yeah. I'm planning to make a video of it and I'll share it, of course, on YouTube. But I wish that it must be shared with you all. And it is regarding the impression with which we, the people of India, are having, and what message we, the people of India, you know, are trying to communicate to our leaders, you know. So it is on that perspective. And the title of this poetry is Main Janta Hoon. And it goes like, ki mala ke guriyon ke jaise har sukh dukh seh leti hoon. Mala ke guriyon ke jaise har sukh dukh geh leti hoon. Mera kya, main janta hoon, seh leti hoon. Yadi tera upkar rahe to bijli pani mil jata hai. Yadi tera upkar rahe to bijli pani mil jata hai. Varna moolbhoot cheezon ke bin bhi main reh leti hoon. Mera kya, main janta hoon, seh leti hoon. अपराधी संरक्षण पाते खुल के अत्याचार मचाते. अपराधी संरक्षण पाते खुल के अत्याचार मचाते. हर पीड़ित की अश्रुधार के साथ में मैं बह लेती हूँ. मेरा क्या, मैं जनता हूँ, सह लेती हूँ. धर्म जाति के नाम पे देखो मैं कितनी विक्षिप्त हुई हूँ. धर्म जाति के नाम पे देखो मैं कितनी विक्षिप्त हुई हूँ. पर उन्मादी भावों में अब भी खुद को दह लेती हूँ. मेरा क्या, मैं जनता हूँ, सह लेती हूँ. मेरे द्वारा ही चुनकर के तुम सत्ता में आते हो. मेरे द्वारा ही चुनकर के तुम सत्ता में आते हो. और तुम्हारे सब कृत्यों को चुन के मैं तह लेती हूँ. मेरा क्या, मैं जनता हूँ, सह लेती हूँ. फिर पंक्तियां हैं कि हर जवान में हर किसान में हो मेरा उत्थान प्रदर्शित. हर जवान में हर किसान में हो मेरा उत्थान प्रदर्शित. बहुत हुआ अब कर दिखलाओ मानक मैं यह देती हूँ. मेरा क्या, मैं जनता हूँ, सह लेती हूँ. और अंतिम पंक्तियां हैं सर, अंतिम पंक्तियां कि वैसे तो मालूम है मुझको तुम पर कोई फर्क न पड़ता. वैसे तो मालूम है मुझको तुम पर कोई फर्क न पड़ता. पर मैं जब व्याकुल होती हूँ तब यूं ही कह देती हूँ. मेरा क्या, मैं जनता हूँ, सह लेती हूँ. थैंक यू सर.
अगर ऐसे व्यूज रहेंगे सब लोग इसको आगे बढ़ाएंगे तो जरूर फर्क पड़ेगा.
जी सर, जी सर. थैंक यू तोशी फॉर इनवाइटिंग मी. ओवर टू यू तोशी.
लवली कंपोजिशन सर, वेरी ब्यूटीफुल लाइंस. आई वुड नाउ रिक्वेस्ट मेजर जनरल पीके शर्मा टू प्रपोज द वर्ड ऑफ थैंक्स एंड एक्सप्रेस हिज व्यूज.
थैंक यू तोशी. इट वॉज रियली वंडरफुल टू हैव दिस वेबिनार ऑन दिस ऑस्पिशियस डे. And I'm very happy that Ms. Vinita Singh could oblige us. Or you know how difficult it was getting her because she has a lot of commitments today.
Yes.
But very thoughtful of her, even though she was traveling. And see, the good point is, she said, I'm not legally qualified. She is not a graduate of law, but still she had wonderful views, invigorating your mind. It is our duty. You know, I noted down certain things which very, very quickly I'll say. She said, securing the values for myself is the first and foremost. So, jab tak hum apne aap ko sahi nahi karenge, apne aap ke baare mein theek nahi sochenge, to what can we do for the society? So, I feel that as a good citizen, I must do it for others also. Right? So, I keep saying, it's a saying that constitution is the mother of all laws. So we need to treat our mother properly. That is very important. You know, a lot of questions are coming up for changing the constitution. Is there actually a need to change the constitution? Are we actually working as per the constitution? If we work as per the guidelines, if we go by the preamble, our constitution is one of the finest constitutions of the country. So much has been done, but so much needs to be done to actually achieve the goals set out by the preamble. So once again, I must thank Toshi for organizing it so well. Ms. Vinita Singh in absentia, we will convey our thanks to her. And Toshi, some of the questions that she could not take because of the time,
yes, sir,
you can please send it to her in writing and we will obtain her written replies from her. Pranshul, thank you so much for this lovely composition. You are going slow. You have promised to publish a book on all this. So make a promise on the Constitution Day that you will now fast pace it. Okay. And thank you, participants. I find huge attendance. That's very nice. There it should have been more, but good. I hope you all are going richer in what Ms. Vinita Singh has said. And we will have more such discourses online, offline, whatever the situation arises. In the afternoon, we have a legal quiz. So I want a large number of you to participate in it. It is being organized in collaboration with Legal Bites. So all the best. I see that even some first semester students are participating in it. That's very, very, very nice. So all the best to you. And once again, thank you, everyone. Have a good day. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much, sir.
May I close the session?
Thank you, Toshi. Sir, one more thing I just want to request, if it is possible, with our IT team. Are we able to unmute all the participants and tell them to switch on their camera? Because if it is possible, we want that we must take a recording, by reiterating preamble of the Constitution. Is it possible?
No, sir, not right now. It's possible because it's a webinar question. So we can't take all of them in a panel, sir. We can take few of them, sir.
So if it is possible to just take around 20-25 persons on screen and then we all recite preamble.
Okay, I am just promoting.
Thank you.
So some of you are now being promoted as panelists. So I request all of you to switch on your camera so that we'll capture this recording and we must send it to the president office and to UGC.
Please switch on your cameras. All those who are being promoted, switch on your cameras. Good. Ashani, photo mat lagao. Please switch on your cameras quickly.
Akhleen, Achal, Ashish, Vasishth.
Jaldi kar, Ashani.
Aditya, Abhishek. Switch on your camera, please.
See, there is no point getting your photographs only. We want you to be there so that when we take the oath, everybody can be seen. Good. Some more cameras. Asha ji, kuch faculties ko bhi kar dijiye, jaise Dr. S.K. Tripathi hain, Dr. Ajay Bhatt.
Sir, please announce. They raise the hand so I can promote them.
Okay. I think Dr. Ajay Bhatt hain, Dr. Vijay Pal hain. Then we have Dr. Sugato. We have Dr. S.K. Tripathi. Agar ye kar sakte hain to?
Sir, jo bachche apna camera on nahi kar rahe, ya to unko hata dijiye. There might be some people who have some issues with their networks.
हाँ जिन जिन के कैमरास ऑन हैं उनको रखना बेटर है.
All the faculties are requested to raise their hand so that IIT persons they promote you as panelist. Faculties raise your hand so that you'll be promoted as panelist. Ajay sir, Dr. S.K. Tripathi and Vijaypal bhai, those who are all are there.
Atul, are you there? Atul Jain, or have they quit?
Nidhi ma'am, Dr. S.K. Tripathi, please switch on your camera. Shweta, Akshit Goyal, Abhishek Verma, Achal Ranjan, Abhay Raj Anand, everybody please switch on your camera.
Dr. Tripathi has come. Yeah, anybody? Dinky, are you there?
Raise your hand, those who are able to switch on their camera, please raise your hand so that you will be promoted as panelist.
Yeah, Vijay, switch on your camera. Vijaypal, switch on your camera. Pranshul, I think we can start.
Yeah, sir.
Aap boliye, then let everybody to repeat. Yeah, Pranshul, start.
Yeah, sir. I'm starting. I am reciting preamble and I request that each one of you must recite with me and I request that if anybody, if it is possible for you to record it on in your cell phone, Toshi, please do that.
Okay, sir.
So we are starting, okay?
आप लोग अपने माइक्स भी ऑन करिए प्लीज स्विच ऑन योर माइक्स आल्सो
स्विच ऑन योर माइक्स आल्सो
ऑन योर सेल या बोलो प्रांशु
अभिषेक मल्होत्रा आशी अक्षित गोयल निधि मैम डॉक्टर अजय कुमार एवरीबॉडी अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ प्लीज ओके वी आर स्टार्टिंग एंड आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू रिसाइट आफ्टर मी पीपल ऑफ इंडिया
We the people of India.
Having solemnly resolved. Constitute India.
Into
a sovereign socialist secular democratic republic. And to secure.
And to secure to all its citizens
Justice, social, economic, and political
liberty
of thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship.
Faith and equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity,
assuring the dignity of the individual. And the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly. On this 26th day of November.
Do hereby.
Adopt, enact, and give to ourselves this constitution. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Mishra ji, we can now close the session.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.